Hey. What up, everybody? We are the Normies, and it's finally time. We have arrived. We made it.
Believe it.
R.I.P. to all the dead homies that didn't make it to this. You know what I mean?
That's true. Like, that's true.
This is 10 fucking years.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot has changed.
I'm on Android, and on my home screen, if you swipe this way, a bunch of like news articles come up, and it's like every third one has been about Grand Theft Auto 6 for the past like 10 years, actually.
Names.
I'm Pat.
I'm Surge.
Mickey.
Yeah.
I'm Miko Bellic.
All right, I'm Surge Versetti.
Surge Versetti? I'm just...
You're
PJ.
You're Trevor.
I'm Trevor.
Forever. Yeah, like, for real though, it's like, I also read somewhere that like we might only have like two or three more GTAs left in our lifetime.
I hope
what I mean, if they're going at this rate, like, we,
but you know what, now all the microtransactions and shit are starting, so we might have had the golden era,
I think you might be right with that. I feel like, I hope it's not going to be like, because like 2K was like that, it was like good, and now it's just a trash because of all the microtransactions. I hope
it's been trash.
I hope they don't do this to GTA, because I love the game, and yeah.
Some people would say it's already there with the shark cards, but full disclosure, huge Grand Theft Auto fans here on the couch. Yeah. We all played the shit out of GTA Online. I played the ever-loving fuck out of it.
I played the fucking 2D over-the-top ones on PC, dude.
Yeah.
I played like the OG.
But like, there are shark cards.
Yeah.
And like, I don't, as long as they make the online stuff attainable, like, don't make it like so hard to farm, I'm okay with shark cards being available for people.
Yeah, that's a little different. I mean, like, I guess it's not like every single
maybe, you know how we all got lucky that one year there was Robin Hood? Maybe we have more freaking Robin Hoods out there.
There's always going to be stuff
the
like
era
that.
Of GTA Online.
I do wonder how, if like GTA Online is going to shut down, or like if they're going to like just upgrade it into this experience, or if it's going to be a brand new GTA. Well, I guess it would have to be. It's a totally different map.
Yeah, it's going to be a new GTA Online, hopefully with way less load times. But I just wanted to dive in real quick with my personal history of GTA. The first GTA I played was GTA 3 on PlayStation 2. I was way too young to have been playing it, but I fucking grew up on these games. Vice City, San Andreas. I even played the Stories games, 4 and 5. The music has always been so good. Like, this, the soundtrack.
I think I've discovered a lot of music through GTA.
Most of the time, people are like, you know that song? It's probably because GTA. I heard it on a GTA radio station.
Yeah.
And so, with Vice City, obviously, that got me into the 80s music as well. We're returning here.
Man.
I'm just very excited that we made it, man.
I'm excited that we're going back to Miami.
I started GTA on PC with like the old school over the top boys. I didn't even know what the game was. I didn't even play the game, really. I'd spent the whole time just driving around, fucking around. I remember you could go to the train station, you could hijack the train, and it was just like a linear track, but I was like, whoa, I'm controlling the train. And then I tried to buy Grand Theft Auto 3 when it first came out. I went to my with my mom. At the time, we had Funko Land. Remember Funko Land?
Yeah.
And I went there. And the guy at the register fucking snitched, dude. He was like, this is rated M. He's not supposed to be playing this. I was like, So I had to play that one at my friend's house in secrecy. And then
you played 3? I don't know.
I did play 3. Vice City, I did manage to get my hands on that one. And that twist at the end is still one of, like, a very memorable...
Fucking Lance Vance?
A very memorable gaming, like, what the fuck are you doing?
What's your foray?
So I didn't get a chance to. The only time I got to play like Grand Theft Auto 3 was either at Walmart or at my friend's house. It was just, I could never play. I never had the game, but I was able only to get Vice City. I was finally able to get Vice City, and that was really my most memorable game because I played the shit out of the game. I liked the aesthetics. I was always into like the Miami vibe and like the Scarface kind of thing. So that aesthetic was my fucking jam. And like, I like San Andreas and all the other ones, but that one was my fucking
favorite.
Did
you find the Easter egg apartment in that?
No,
where you could get the chainsaw in the bathtub?
No, I did not.
Vice City at the time was like the map was small enough that you could like memorize it.
Yeah, and that's why that was easier for me.
And I knew all the nooks and crannies, every alley. Oh, God, it was so good.
GTA 5, though, we played a lot. I kind of remember, like, I even thought of it now. I know how to get from Los Santos to the countryside. Like, you know what I mean?
Oh,
like the highway on the right
highway,
by the casino. and there's like that long haul highway to like the airfield.
Once you hit the highway, yeah, but like all the intricate like nooks and crannies of like the city, dude, it is insane like how just intricate it is now. So yeah. I'm excited what they've pulled out in 10 years. This is about to be insane.
It's time, guys. No further delay. I know you're tired of hearing us yapping. Or if you forwarded, here's the point where you stop forwarding. Here's the reaction. Fucks, you could have listened to us talk. Come on. 4K, oh, right?
Come on,
4K.
Yeah, come on, dude. What the hell? Come on, dude.
Why is it not the default?
Oh, my God, dude. Oh, my God.
Yeah, let's make sure all the volume is all Gucci.
No. Pause it, dude. What are you doing?
All right, here we go, guys. Ooh, I know, obviously, we're going to play it back and pause.
Yeah.
But let's go.
Let's go.
Lucia. Do you know why you're here?
Bad luck, I guess.
This should look good.
Look at that water. It looks insane.
The water already, my God.
And we're back, baby.
The
Gators shit, probably.
Oh, this is gonna be so good.
Dude, I know that building. We've already been to some of these clubs, Pat.
Yeah, I know, bro. Oh, my God. Cleveland Hotel.
Old school.
All right, the graphics are dumb real.
The bridges.
And the girls.
Hey, we got fucking social media back on this. TikTok. There's the Gators.
This is insane.
We're going to have an actual Florida man.
Yeah, this is going to be cool.
Well, look who's back.
Oh, God.
Trevor's grandmother?
We can get through this. Is by sticking together, being a team.
Oh my God.
Trust.
The stallion.
Trust.
Yeah.
Yo. Yeah. It's B.I. like Vice. Like B.I. like six. The first two letters of Vice.
Bro. This? Yes.
Oh my God.
I'm fucking excited.
2020.
Why we gotta wait? Come on. I'm gonna be two years older.
I knew it.
I think since GTA 4, they've released the trailers like 2-3 years in advance. Like, I still remember that first GTA 4 trailer. Like, I killed people.
Yeah.
Smuggled people.
Oh my God, dude. The graphics are insanely realistic. Man, I can't believe I'm saying this, but like, yeah, I don't think kids should be like, it's like a little too real looking now, dude. Like we grew up, the kids are used to this stuff. We grew up with like pixelated blood splatters. This is like ultra, because like with Red Dead Redemption, man, like the level of detail in there, like they bleed from like each individual wound. Like it's like ultra realistic. But I'm glad to. It's just insane. I'm more just like, I want to say speechless, but I
always forget that like. You know, these are like the story modes are always biting social satire for like the time period we're in.
Yeah.
And they're setting this in modern, even more modern day, where GTA 5 was like 2013 modern day. This is 10 years later. And we got like a lot of social media, TikTok looking things. Cause like, I didn't expect that in GTA 4, you had the internet cafe.
Dude, look at these.
In GTA 5, you had like the Twitter and shit. But like now, like, I think social media is going to play a big part in this game.
It's got to, because, man, you see the shadows of the car light on the fucking water down there?
Yeah, that's ray tracing.
That is fucking crazy,
That's
man.
Ray tracing, dude.
That is wild.
And look at the puddles and stuff. There's going to be, like, a crazy dynamic weather system.
You usually got to hit the strip club to see Jiggle like this.
So we saw the city, we saw the Everglades, we saw the, like, the ocean highway, we saw, like, the, like, people mudding. So there's gonna be, like, a variety of, like, locations.
This grab is nuts. America!
I wonder if NPCs are gonna do crazy shit and you have the option to, like, record it and put it on social media or some shit.
Yeah, like maybe, like...
You know, like, you have to see what's going down.
Maybe you have to, like, get followers and, like, that's how you get respect and shit, you know what I mean?
Because nowadays it's all about how you're influencing people, how many influence.
Dude, not only you gotta be a criminal, but you gotta be, like, an influencer.
Look at the speckles in the car paint, dude. Like, look at the foliage in the back.
And you can see the Instagram handle, so you probably look up people's Instagram handle while you walk. Oh,
that might be a big part of online mode, too. Like, imagine online, you have to have your own handle and, like...
Dude, this is gonna be so cool. People are gonna have their own second life in this.
I bet... look at this.
Look
people
at the
are, like,
mud.
Mudding and shit.
They
dude.
Really showed, like, they wanted to show every versatile thing, like the mud on their skin right here.
Yeah, man. This
crazy.
Is
crazy.
Crazy.
Yeah, fine, though.
How
crazy,
does the graphics get crazy. So much better each time?
I mean, it's 10 years. It better be like, dude, what's insane I loved all the, like, they showed the two bridges that lead to, like, the middle island in Vice City.
She looks too real. Where the mansion was.
Yeah.
We saw that. I saw some of the old school cars from Vice City. There was, like, that, like, white Ferrari Testarossa looking car. I think it was called a Jaguar, maybe, or something like that. But, like, there were a few little things.
I know too many GTA car names and no real life names. Infernus, Cheetah, fucking Stinger. Yeah, dude, she looks way too real. This looks like we paused an actual Karen TikTok or some shit. Like,
that's what I'm saying, dude. I think NPCs are just going to be doing dumb shit and, like, you can record it. I hope that's what it is.
It's going to be so fun.
Because I would make, like, the level of interacting with NPCs just that much and more insane. And like
they wouldn't be showing it off this much in the trailer if it wasn't a big part of the game. You know what I mean?
Hey, Pat, you stayed in a place like that.
I did.
Kind of.
That is too realistic. I'm sorry.
That's what I'm saying, man. Like, this is going to be violent.
I know. Man, and I remember some of
He looks a little Nico Bellic-ish.
He looks nothing like Nico Bellic.
In the eyes. In the nose bridge area.
No.
Yeah, dude. Like the
He's
nose.
He's a white
guy.
Like
no, I'm not saying he is Nico Bellic. I'm saying he looks-ish. Like right here. Just like
I don't see it.
In the bridge.
At one bit. But I wanted to look at the... this is the satire shit. Look, it cures emotions. Like, this is the shit that I love.
America's
GTA
favorite dissociation.
Dissociate. The thing that
I even got, like, the Pfizer logo.
That, the thing that GTA
hated, called Fix.
Look at the cop car, man. I'm marveling at this. Is this a cutscene? Yeah. There's not real cutscenes, right? They just kind of bleed into the main.
And we're probably gonna have first person off the bat. Cause one of the videos they showed a little first person view. It's
a little bit more intuitive.
It's just like, look at like how long the draw distance is and just like how it blurs. It's just like the layers of effects like make it look just so ultra realistic. It's just insane.
Man,
look at the sun and the lighting. Like it feels like tropical sun. It's like really beating down, you know?
The haters that like don't like GTA or say it's just for people trying to like live out their like gangster fantasies, they don't understand like that the stories have been good, like literally I think since GTA 3, well really since Vice City, the stories have been like really good. And it has something to say. It's biting social satire, like I keep saying. And it's like, it's making fun of our world. It doesn't take itself too seriously, except in the characters. The characters, they take themselves seriously and you can latch onto them, but the world is like fantastical enough for you to be like, oh, they're making fun of this shit. You know
but
what
like,
I mean?
Rockstar is the only company that's ever made like a realistic world that feels lived in, and it feels like a city. Like most video game cities, it's like, okay, yeah, this is like a video game, but like Los Santos, like it feels like they're city planning.
Yeah,
like you can see the transition from the burbs to like the city part. And it's like it all
the attention to detail.
They have such a. Yeah. I bet they have like actual city planners like on their team helping design shit. Like it's just like, it's a marvel. Like whatever you want to say about it, like this is a marvel of engineering. This is a marvel of like artistry to its highest level, in my opinion. Like it's insane what they managed to build every single time.
Look at that, what it says. Someone called the Department of Support a dump truck. Not only they got like the Miami like vibes and everything down, but they got the women down.
They got the booty at the Miami
the
booty
big
right
women
there.
Down, bro. They got it
big
down.
Big booty.
They got it down.
Bro, oh my god, so there is gonna be like a comprehensive animal system. Like
that's
we saw Flamingo.
Look at that.
Right there. Go to the bridge.
That is fucking phenomenal.
Okay, that's not the middle. I was like,
that's crazy.
You know the middle island where the mansion was?
There was animals in GTA 5. There was a big animal system there, but I think
you could hunt deer.
You could see a lot of
you could hunt deer for
bunnies
deer
and rabbits and dogs.
Yeah, the water looks insane. So I wonder if this is going to be completely different from the old Vice City map or if they're like building onto it.
It's going to be more like Miami.
Okay, you see this old bridge? Maybe that was the old bridge because remember it just went straight through and maybe this is like the new bridge and that is the middle island, but it's like different now.
I don't think it's basing itself off of the original Vice City map, but I see what you're saying. I know there was like two big islands and then one small island where your mansion was.
I feel like that's
but
just
I think
Key
this
West.
Is just like this. They're reimagining it to make it like more like all of Florida.
Yeah.
Like Florida in general, because we got the swamps, we got the what'd you say like the not the Keys, but what'd you call it?
where the Everglades.
The Everglades, yeah.
And then like the city, like I remember some of these hotels.
Go right there. Yeah, this, like Sunset Strip. You see this white car? Remember that? You could get that.
Yeah.
Is that the actual Ferrari logo? Do they have actual licenses?
But probably not, but looks like it. Very similar. That, like, this is like legit fucking really the real, boardwalk, but dude. The building, because like, I know that fucking Cleveland.
Is this Brickell?
No, well, not Brickell. It looks like Brickell. It's South Miami.
Bro, man, this is going to be fucking... Look how just the draw distance and like how it blurs into the background. Like it's just,
I can't
like,
wait to drive around this fucking
the
city.
The depth of field. That's
I just want to drive in that.
That's my favorite part about Grand Theft Auto. When I go in there, I don't even play the game, really. I just like to drive around and like marvel.
This man, it. Every time we got done with the most intricate heist that it takes forever to do, we got like 2 million. We're like, oh my God, all right, let's what can I spend this on? Like, Mickey's like, I already spent it. Immediately on his car appraise. Yeah, we never saw his cars. He just kept them in his garage.
Like, well, what am I trying to build a 401k? Like, it's a game.
Yeah. It's just funny how shockingly fast you're like, I already spent it. We're just like, what do we buy?
Yeah, I don't know what to get.
And it was all like on the engine upgrades in your car.
Yeah, I had some sick cars. I had some sweet cars.
We're going to see the real. Oh my God. This
shit looks insane.
So good.
That's what I was talking about. That club. I've seen that building. Haven't we?
Yeah. Just like with the lines and shit in there.
And with the concrete buildings in the background. Like, this is like straight up Miami, dude. It's more
realistic Miami. Look at the how populated the beach is.
Look at the tracks on the beach. Man. That's fucking nuts. People walking tracks are still there. Bike tracks are there.
You can see the truck in the background.
Like, we got a little doggy too. We got a little chihuahua. Skis.
I mean, they're straight up like tankers and shit. Like cargo ships out there. Like, I wonder. Yeah, I wonder,
like a barge and shit.
Oh my God.
But yeah, we got little doggos back, little Miami Chihuahua. Yeah. I wanted to see the shot of the Everglades because that looked fucking crisp.
With the flamingos?
Oh yeah, the flamingos.
With the flamingos, dude.
Like, look at that.
That is nuts.
Oh my God.
Look how many animals. Okay, wait. Pause. Because you can see way in the back, you can see like
there's a gator
deer,
right there. Gators,
flamingos. Fucking
there's like a whatever, deer or four legged like
white ones are cranes
at the very back
and like regular ducks too, quails or
dude,
something.
Dude, there's like 10 different animals in there.
That is so people tanning and stuff. This looks too real, man. This was everything we wanted, guys. This was everything we wanted.
Look at a little chihuahua.
I know, that's why I mentioned that there's gonna be dogs. That's what
we haven't even talked about the main character. Like it's just
I know. Look, Lucia looked fine.
Yeah, she
and
does.
I think so, she's going to be a great main character.
I think if we're just sticking with Lucia the whole time, that's awesome. But like because Grand Theft Auto, you could like switch between people. I would imagine they want to do it again. And because it's like her and some other dude, I want to say maybe we'll be able to switch between both of them.
That would be neat. Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't mind that. That was a cool dynamic in the fifth one. But if it was also just her,
yeah,
and a
more
personal story.
I'm down with that, too.
Like
I'm down with that.
I'm getting more GTA 4 Nico Bellic vibes from this story.
Yeah.
Possibly. Just right off the top.
A little Bonnie and Clyde adventure, dude.
Yeah. But like
look at, so yeah, dude, getting, look how, dude.
Getting out of jail.
Look at
it's
the.
It's like jail uniform, right?
Look at like looking through the glass, how it like, God, how do they fucking do this
her
shit?
Eyebrow, bro. Your eyebrows how are good do, for being in
you
prison.
You can see the right pores in her skin on her forehead, like little bumps. Like, how do they do
she
this?
She looks a little too good for prison.
How did they do this?
All right, so she just gets out of jail and immediately just did not learn her lesson.
No. Fuck it.
What does that say over there?
99. Why still 9 when you can 99?
Why 69 when you can 99?
Oh, why 69 when you're 99?
What is a 99?
99? Maybe it's like some kind of alcohol.
Bro,
this is...
You know, whatever speculation, we've
like
heard some
every
good things.
Frame has so much going on. Like, every single frame. Look at that! Look at that! Bottle service!
All Miami culture, man.
Bro!
So, I don't know what's... In all GTA games... There's not ever a invisible wall except for when you cross the ocean.
Right,
so, like,
yeah.
I'm assuming all these buildings are accessible.
Oh,
right?
yeah.
Like,
of
we're
course.
Not going to have an invisible wall. Like, you can't go to that island.
No.
I feel like all this shit is accessible right
yeah.
now.
Yeah. That's one thing that I'm playing Spider-Man 2, and you can see, like, buildings, like, way off in the distance, but you know.
Yeah, you can't.
But
you
know,
go,
you can't go there, and you're like, wow.
Yeah. This is like. They've upgraded it. Because remember when GTA 4 and 5 came out, we're like, man, how are the graphics going to get better than this? Look at the twerk physics. They must have actually motion captured someone twerking.
Yo. Right here. This is where the first person.
Oh, I see it.
I think.
Well, that looks like body cam footage.
Yeah, it is.
This is like police body cam footage.
But again, they have the first person mechanic already in GTA 5. So
that's cool.
I think they could make it better, but maybe police body cam stuff might come into like.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe you can like.
Because we're talking about how satire it is. Like, yeah. They're gonna bring this up.
Florida is a fucked up place, man.
You're gonna have the person on bath salts eating someone's face.
I think there's just gonna be crazy shit happening in this game all the fucking time, and
you're right. I think the online mode, everybody kind of, you might have like a social media type thing where like players kind of have like followings and shit. Like maybe we'll be able to follow players.
Weasel News is back. No, like the news might play a big. I don't know what else to say.
Who is he supposed to be, like the Joker?
That for some reason gives me like character creator vibes. Like that looks like a creative character. This does,
yeah. I don't know. It does look very Joker or Saints Row-esque.
Unless we can translate that. Man looks Confession, like, Escrita, and Teen. I don't know. I don't want to.
He looks straight out of Saints Row. By sticking together. Biker gang. Being a
team. Yeah. Man. Cops fail to. Yeah, it is going to be a lot of like. It's definitely.
Lucy, you know how many people are going to be thirsting for Lucia?
Bro, I'm already thirsting for Lucia.
I'm already thirsting for Lucia.
I want to play her.
She can fix me.
She can fix you.
You're gonna be this asshole. I hope he doesn't betray her.
Look at him. Look at the look in his eyes.
He's about to tear it up.
She can fix me. I'll rob a grocery store with you if you can justify it enough.
Yeah. What
a trailer.
All right. Well, guys, I don't know if there's much more to say. Coming 2025.
What a flippin' trailer.
And that song is great, too. You know it's going to be in the game. Because any song they use in the trailer is a song on a radio station in the game.
Now we're going to watch trailer breakdowns.
Yeah.
50 things you missed in the GTA trailer.
Let us know, guys, what are you most looking forward to? What was your favorite GTA experience? It doesn't have to be graphics, story. Like, you personally, what was your favorite experience? And then we'll see you guys.
And if you do this for me, you will be a made man.
You'll be a made man.
Anything you want.
Oh, man, Nico. The fucking music in GTA 4, like, the original music, still lives in my head rent-free.
Dude, Flock of Seagulls Run is one of my is one of my favorite songs, and that was Vice City. I wouldn't have discovered it otherwise.
Yeah. All right, gang. See ya.
See ya.
Bye. Man.